Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will learn how to validate a textbox using EditForm component in the Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor component. Look at this example, you will see the editor displaying a custom error below when the name field has a long text or is empty. Now, I will show you the code to validate a textbox using EditForm component in an existing Blazor application. Here, I have added the Blazor Textbox component to the Blazor In-Place Editor component, and I have defined the basic properties like t-value and bind-value. Follow the link provided in the card to learn the basics of adding a Blazor In-Place Editor to an app. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. Look at the output page, it displays a text box with the default input value, Andrew. Notice here, there is no validation message when the input value is empty. If I want to show an error message when the name field is empty, I need to set a custom validation to the editor component. To add validations, first define the Blazor EditForm component within the editor component and add the text box component inside the EditForm definition. Then, I add data annotations validator component to attach the validation support. So, let me define the data annotations validator component within this EditForm component and import the namespace system component model data annotations. Next, to create a model for the component, let me add a class named validation model and add this string variable inside this model class. Then, I define the required attribute to specify that a data field value is required. Now, I create an object named example of type validation model within this code block. Now, I assign this class to the model property of the EditForm component. And then, I change the bind value property value to example.name. As I said before, I am going to show an error message when the input value of the text box is empty. Therefore, let me add a validation message tag and specify the field example.name for which validation message should be displayed. Now, look at the editor component, the error message, the name field is required is displayed below the text box. When I type in long text, the text box accepts it. To restrict the text box input value length, I simply need to add the string length attribute and set the required length. As you can see, when the input value exceeds the defined maximum length, the editor shows the default error message. If you want to show a custom error message, pass the error message as name is too long within the string length attribute. Look at the output page now. When the input value exceeds the maximum length, the defined custom message is shown below the text box. Let's summarize what we have covered in this video. I showed you how to validate a textbox in the Blazor In-Place Editor component when the input value is empty, and how to restrict the input value length and show the custom error message. If you would like to see the working example of the editor component used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.